The legend of the Stinky Crow. Gaul, Gaul! For nearly 14 years, his mind had been soaring miles above. But Elliot Thomas was still stuck down on Earth, in the boring town of Sinchester. Sinchester.
Sinster.
What?
It's pronounced Sinster.
How do you know?
My cousin's from Sinster. Never mind, keep going.
Alone in his treehouse, he glued feathers to his wingsuit, readying himself for the day he would join the Phoenixes and Quetzalcoatls in the sky. Dinner time, cried his mother from their house across the yard. Elliot sat at the center of the table. A TV dinner was challenge his B.O. as the dominant smell in the room. On his left, his mother yammered about her day at the ER. On his right, his father was absorbed in his smartphone. As for Elliot, his eyes were fixed on the ceiling fan, the most fascinating personality within a 10-foot radius. In homeroom the next day, Justin Schmuckovsky threw a crappy paper airplane at him. Within seconds, Elliot had built a superior vessel. He stood up on his chair and swiftly launched the Papier Flieger. What? At his unsuspecting enemy.
Go, Papier Flieger, go!
Zoom, splort, splort. The marvel of paper aviation lodged itself in Justin's tender eyeball. Mr. Thomas, bellowed their teacher. Go to the principal's office. Later that day, Elliot was cooing quietly to himself as he bought a candy bar in the lobby. Casey Witchtits was smoking nearby and sneered at him. You'll never fly, Stinky Crow, she laughed. Why don't you go jack off to some bird porn? I bet you do more fapping than flapping.
Hey, that's pretty good.
Fuck you, screeched Elliot as he ran for the door. It was dark out by the time Elliot meandered home. On the sidewalk, he passed a gaunt man who stared at him intently, desperately even.
Uh-oh, stranger danger.
The man opened his mouth and said, Uviwa, Uviza! What the fuck? Elliot had planned to eat his candy bar tonight while he finished his masterpiece, but he instead held it out to the man. I know what you mean, he replied. The schoolyard was packed the next morning as Elliot's classmates waited for first bell. Go, go! As one, the students turned toward the gate and saw Elliot dressed head to toe in his wingsuit. After a moment of shock, they burst into laughter. But they were already far below him. He swooped through their midst and into the school. Call, call! He bounded through the halls, zigzagged up the stairwell. Call! The school let out a collective gasp when they saw a Stinky Crow on the roof. With a triumphant snap, he spread his wings, and a moment later, he had leapt. The next 2 seconds were the most beautiful of Elliot's entire life. He could feel their eyes upon him. He was flying, and their awe was keeping him aloft. 10 minutes later, as guidance counselors wiped bits of Elliot off sobbing students, and the police struggled to piece together the story you are reading now. Elliot's teacher looked down at the wreckage of the boy on the pavement and never forgot what he saw. One bloody hand had formed a peace sign. The other was giving him the finger. It's like an Alanis Morissette song. The end.
Okay, lovely. I don't think I'll sleep for weeks.
Quidad cojones.
I would hate to be the dumbass that got tricked into renting that cabin. See y'all real soon.
Boy, she just loves you to pieces. Run! Look, there's a key. We'd better kill all the demons in case they've got more.
Drop it.
You first.
Why do I get the sense you and me are in the same line of work?
Wasting hell, monkeys? Who says it's work?
Uh-huh. Just stay out of my way, friendo. I'm in a hurry.
Hurry to do what?
Mind your own fucking business.
Fine. You stay out of my way. As long as I stay out of yours.
Good. Hard men like us don't mix.
Wait. Is that a comma?
Hard like hardened. Experienced. Just forget it.
I don't think I ever will.
Now, if you'll excuse me.
Have fun.
Just remember.
I stay out of your way, you stay out of mine.
Bingo.
Look, G, what are those newspaper articles?
It says, local woman dies in grisly murder.
Maria Domenico, a native of Langosta, was found dead early Thursday morning outside her suburban home. She was 29 years old. According to local police, her skin... her skin has been completely removed. Good Lord. She is survived by her husband, Colonel... that's weird. The name has been X'd out.
Ah! go!
Paula, I swear I'm coming!
Garcia, I don't think I can make it.
Fuck!
Fuck you! You dickwad!
Fuck you!
Out of my way! This one's mine.
Hey.
The one I loved was taken away by this fiend. I don't know why she died, but that question no longer concerns me. All I want now is to have her back. But I have the deep feeling that's not gonna happen. Because the flesh that hangs from this fucker's body looks all too familiar. This is your death, hell beast!
One hard man.
Fuck! 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 Fuck!
Here I come, fucker!
Magnifico.
Go on, G. I'm ready for insertion.
To start World War III, I tell you what.